Welcome, everyone. At the outset of our presentation, we'll be discussing BEMS. We are engineering students from Ain Shams University. We are Osama Mohammed, Mohammed Khalid, Mariam Yasa, Mahmoud Mohammed, and Mohammed Hamid. To begin with, the aim of our project is to design a comprehensive building management system with optimal solutions encompassing various technical, economical, and managerial aspects. To achieve our aim, we need to organize our ideas into several objectives, namely, to achieve green energy with high performance and at optimum cost, utilizing communication methods to facilitate easy access to control devices and data. Our journey starts with implementing the BEMS system by studying an administrative building and exploring how we can apply the system to it. In any system, we find it comprises three fundamental components: supply, control, and load. This leads us initially to begin with the supply aspect. Introducing the Solis kit, which forms the backbone of our project's supply component. This kit helps us understand how solar and wind energy can power buildings effectively. The supply kit, Solis, is utilized for the application and examination of a solar panel and a wind turbine combined with a group of batteries and an uninterruptible power supply, UPS. Let's break down the key parts of the Solis kit and what they do. Solar panel captures sunlight and converts it into electrical energy. Wind turbine converts wind energy into rotational motion, generating electricity. The wind turbine has a single body and sits on top of the chassis. Its blades, powered by the wind, are provided separately. The turbine's shaft connects to an electric motor using belts and toothed pulleys. This electric motor is controlled by the control box to simulate different wind conditions. Batteries store excess energy generated for later use or during low production periods. Battery charger regulates the charging process to ensure optimal battery performance and longevity. Twido PLC, programmable logic controller for automation and control of the system. Ethernet coupler facilitates communication between different components of the system. It enables system access from the LAN with specific web pages for data viewing and commands. Regulator controls the flow of energy to maintain stable voltage levels. Inverter converts direct current, DC, from the solar panels and wind turbine into alternating current, AC, for use in electrical systems. The Solis kit offers flexible usage modes tailored to varying energy requirements and scenarios. 1. Standalone on batteries. Utilizes renewable sources to charge batteries, providing uninterrupted power supply. In this installation type, generators, solar and wind, are used to charge batteries. The operating current is generated from the batteries. 2. Grid connected integrates with the grid, allowing surplus energy to be fed back, reducing dependency on batteries and ensuring continuous power availability. When power is high, the installation can be connected to the grid via a specific UPS and an additional energy meter. In this case, the installation produces electricity during the day with sunshine or when wind speed is sufficient, which is injected into the grid. Batteries are no longer necessary. Let's take a tour through the HMI interface of this kit. Navigating through the HMI interface, we encounter key parameters and functionalities essential for system monitoring and control. In the main menu, we will see four options. Wind speed monitors wind conditions for optimal turbine performance. Charge mode selects the preferred charging mode based on energy availability and requirements. Battery charge displays battery status, including charge level and remaining autonomy. Consumption tracks energy consumption patterns and sources. In the wind speed menu, we can see two sub-menus. Putting in operation initiates the wind speed monitoring functionality. Setting wind speed allows users to set thresholds for wind speed, based operations from 1 meter per second to 15 meters per second. Charging modes menu has four options: solar plus wind, where you can charge the batteries using both the solar panel and the wind turbine. The second option is using wind only or using solar only. Alternatively, the grid-only option becomes useful, particularly on cloudy days with little to no wind. The battery charge menu. This menu monitors battery health and performance metrics. Battery charge displays current battery charge level as a percentage and voltage. Also, it shows whether or not the battery is charging. The next submenu is current menu, indicates the currents of the batteries, solar panel, and wind. The autonomy submenu estimates the duration for which the system can operate solely on battery's power. In the consumption menu, you can gain insights into energy consumption and utilization patterns where it has two submenus. Source used identifies the primary energy source supplying the load, where the first field indicates the source used to supply the load socket. It can be battery if battery voltage is greater than 23.3 volts, or mains if battery voltage is less than 24.4 volts. Energy quantifies energy consumption over time, facilitating efficient resource management. It is calculated from instantaneous power, for example, mean calculation over 360 samples every 10 seconds. Now, let's delve into the control part.
To connect the supply with any load, a control panel is required to control the flow of power between them. This is the function of the smart panel. The smart panel contains various devices that will be mentioned later that allow the control of the system. For example, it allows load X to consume the power generated by the PV system, or lets load Y be operated by the wind system. It also controls the time of operation of the loads, when it turns on according to certain circumstances, or any scenario required to operate the system. It is all managed by the smart panel. The smart panel acts as an interface between the loads and the supply and gathers data from them and gives us the capability to use this data to take actions based on it. For a panel to be named a control panel, it must include devices that achieve the following tasks. Power reading. To control data, we need to have access to it first. This is done by devices such as power meters or power tags, which receive data about the consumption of the loads. Data receiving. While some power meters have built-in screens to read the data, retrieving this data remotely allows for an easier and more convenient way of monitoring the system. Devices like SmartLink receive this data from power metering devices and can upload it to a cloud for data monitoring and storage. Sending signals. To control the load's on and off operation, signals are sent from SmartLink or controllers to control switches. Load switching. Switches such as contactors, relays, or integrated control circuit breakers are connected before the load to turn on and off based on the signal received. Here are some of the main components implemented in our smart panel. Power meter monitors the main quantities required to control a load, such as current, volt, active and reactive power, energy, harmonics, etc. It also has a built-in monitor that presents the readings on it. Power tag is a wireless power measuring device connected to SmartLink, and its data can be accessed through the web page of the SmartLink. ACTI-9 SmartLink is the main component of the control system. It receives the data sent by metering devices and displays it onto a screen using Ethernet connection. The master SmartLink is connected to the main PC, while all the slave SmartLinks send the data received through them to the master, by which it is connected to using a set address. Integrated control circuit breaker, the IC60 reflex, is a circuit breaker with a built-in motor that can be controlled to turn on and off the connected load via incoming signal. This device can be controlled by controlling it through the web interface of the SmartLink, or using any code development tool. Now let's dive into the control aspect, where we utilize two readily available tools. First, we have Node-RED, enabling us to control the components. Second, there's HiveMQ, a cloud solution for remote control. Our initial step was to identify what aspects of the supply and load we needed to control. For the supply, our focus was on controlling the contactors, responsible for load management and battery charging. we could choose between the grid, PV, or wind sources for charging and determine when to draw power from batteries. Here we employed a microcontroller like Arduino to operate the contactors, facilitated by Node-RED, with custom nodes, all interconnected with the cloud. Similarly for the loads, we utilized a smart panel instead of Arduino for enhanced control and data collection from components. The SmartLink serves as the interconnection tool, bridging between components and Node-RED, linked to the cloud. Here's a simple example of controlling IC60 reflex to turn on/off using these nodes. We apply the same approach to control other components, issuing commands or reading data. Lastly, the cloud serves as the system's hub for simplified control, eliminating the need for Node-RED. Everything is now accessible via a user-friendly mobile application. Moreover, we can store and manage this data, perhaps in an Excel sheet format, for future use. This is just the beginning with the available basics. To build a comprehensive system, we must delve deeper into understanding our loads and their exact requirements.
At the beginning of our discussion with the loads, we'll talk about the ventilation kit, which is a circuit for a motor connected to a fan. The fan raises air inside a duct, representing a load. Let's mention briefly its components. First is a power meter from the PM3000 series with Modbus RTU communication, an EGX300 gateway that switches Modbus RTU to TCP, an ATV32 variable speed drive for motor speed control, and finally, a motorized fan. The fan has a diaphragm to control the flow of air inside the air duct. To communicate with the kit and retrieve data, we can connect with devices like the power meter and VSD. The VSD has an RJ45 port for communication using Modbus RTU and can be programmed via software like SoMove or accessed through Power Commission. The power meter communicates similarly via Modbus RTU, with a gateway provided for easier access to real-time data and trends. Regarding motor connections, DOL and VSD are available. The DOL and VSD allow us to convert single-phase input to three-phase output. The drive also features a potentiometer for frequency control, enabling motor speed adjustment. The advantage of using a drive over direct motor connection lies in the energy consumption, especially when controlling flow with devices like dampers or diaphragms. Using a drive can significantly reduce power consumption over time compared to using dampers, particularly when not operating at full flow. To verify these benefits practically, we can communicate with the power meter through the gateway using an Ethernet cable, accessing its web interface to monitor real-time data. This is a list to select what value exactly is required to be monitored. In the DAL connection, starting current can be clearly noticed, which reached a maximum of 2.277 ampere. While in VSD, starting and stopping are much smoother. This graph was generated from real collected data, can illustrate the differences in power consumption between different control methods, confirming the efficiency of using a drive. Moving on to the VSD, this was the most challenging part, but we successfully learned how to insert the data of the motor, control the motor speed locally and terminally, set the ramp up and down time, set the maximum frequency at which we want to operate, configure Modbus network, run after a break in the power supply, and control speed via preset speeds. Preset speeds provide another means of adjusting speed through logical inputs. By reserving logical input 1 and 2 for forward and reverse operation, we can set LI3 and LI4 for speed control by a combination of two on-off signals, which gives 4 speeds in return. We have another load in our system, the pump with solar drive. This innovative system can be powered by either solar energy or the electrical network, with the power supply mimicking that of a photovoltaic panel. The management of solar power is efficiently handled by the Altivar 312 solar drive. The kit comprises several components, including a storage tank for water retention, a groundwater system simulating a reservoir, and a centrifugal pump load regulated by an Altivar 312 solar drive for optimal control. in fluid mechanics, fluid flow, pressure, and power consumption are directly related to motor speed. Specifically, fluid flow is proportional to motor speed, while fluid pressure and consumed power increase with the square and cube of motor speed, respectively. Controlling motor speed significantly influences power consumption. Implementing variable speed drives, VSD, optimizes energy usage by adjusting motor speed and output, leading to energy savings. The figure illustrates a notable contrast in power consumption between direct online and variable speed drive setups, both operating at a consistent 90% load. Specifically, the variable speed drive configuration demonstrates a remarkable 35% reduction in power consumption compared to direct online, showcasing the energy-saving potential of VSD technology. Our objective is to regulate the pump drive via our intelligent panel, aligning it with the prevailing load and supply conditions. Our smart controller autonomously directs the speed drive to adjust its frequency based on energy demand, leveraging our capability to remotely communicate with the drive for seamless operation. Another critical load we prioritize for optimization is lighting. We utilize our lighting control systems using programmable schedules. The BMS facilitates the creation of lighting schedules tailored to occupancy patterns, time of day, or specific events, optimizing energy consumption by ensuring lights are activated only when necessary. Our goal is to regulate lighting by establishing programmable schedules aligned with the building's operating hours. Different modes are configured, managed by the microcontroller through our smart panel. Our aim is to develop a fully automated smart system capable of adapting to various factors such as weather conditions and electricity tariffs. Additionally, we strive to remotely control the entire system and gather data, which will be uploaded to the cloud for analysis. This data will then be used to generate graphs illustrating consumption patterns, creating a comprehensive simulation of a smart system for an energy-efficient building with minimal power consumption and sustainable practices. Thank you for your attention. For any inquiries, please feel free to reach out to us.